Welcome to my 7th class of Laplace transform. Now here I am considering some more standard results. What we discussed up to the 6th class is now sufficient to solve the problem for using Laplace transform very easily. Therefore, consider some more 2 standard results are, if Laplace transform of f of t is capital F of s, then Laplace transform of t power of n into f of t is nothing but minus 1 to the power of n nth derivative of capital F of s with respect to s. This formula is very much useful whenever having product of t or t square t cube into any function, maybe exponential or whatever trigonometric function, whatever may be. In such cases, instead of obtaining directly Laplace transform, just you take other than t as f of t, find out Laplace transform. What's the power of t based on the total differentiate? Instead of integrate, differentiation is very easy. Therefore, we have to adopt this is one of the standard result while solving some problems. The next another one standard result is, if this is a product of t, next standard result is the quotient of t. If f of t is equal to Laplace transform of f of t is f capital F of s, then Laplace transform of f of t by t is can be written as s to infinity capital F of s ds. Means if you want to go for this function, first you take f of t, find out Laplace. What we get, you integrate s to infinity, that is nothing but solution of directly apply the Laplace transform for f of t by t. Therefore, we have to adapt these two. Observe carefully, first result is very much useful whenever having product of t. The second result is very useful whenever having denominator having a t. Like that, maximum we are taking t square also are possible, but it's very tedious. We have to integrate twice like that for us to infinity. Now, first function is already entered on the board, t to the power of minus 4t into sin 3t. Now, here the trigonometric function is there, exponential function is there, and also polynomial is there. How to take very easily, means how to find out very easily Laplace transform of this without doing any complicated for this. What we are going to do here, first you take other than t and exponential function, what's other than that? Trigonometric function. First you write what's the Laplace transform of that. At that time we can't apply all the 3 functions. Therefore, what I am going to do here, what is my Laplace transform of sin 3t? Is nothing but f 3 divided by s square plus 3 square. What is 3 square? Is 9. After that, you have to take along with the t. Now, don't take shifting property. First, you take along with t because you know that to take t, you have to differentiate. Therefore, what we are going to do, that implies Laplace transform of t into sin 3t is nothing but, now the power of t is 1, if I have to differentiate once, minus 1 to the power of 1, the first derivative of f of s. What is my f of s? 3 by s square plus 9. Now, I do differentiate this, I keep minus is a constant. You take s square plus 9 is numerator, what we get? Minus 1 into s square plus 9 to the power of all way that you have to subtract 1, we get minus 1, minus 1 is minus 2. Into derivative of s square with respect to s is 2s plus derivative constant is 0. Now, I have to simplify this, what we get? 3 2s are 6, minus into minus plus 6s divided by s square plus 9 whole square. This is nothing but Laplace transform of t into sin 3t. But still have exponential. I go for which property? Shifting property. Shifting property is Laplace transform of e power of dt f of t is nothing but what is that actually? Capital F of s minus a, where Laplace transform of f of t is equal to capital F of s. This is my shifting property. Now, why I am going to apply shifting property? Because you are having exponential. By shifting property, keep in mind before going to apply the property, must and should write the name of the property. Otherwise, they are not understanding. So, anyone will go through an answer. We get Laplace term, no need to write entire result, just you write the name of the property. T into e power of minus 4t into sin 3t. This can be written as Yeah, you already know the t into sin 3t. Replace s by s minus a. What is my a? Minus 4. We get s plus a. Therefore, what we get? 6 into s plus 4. Because a here, a is what? Minus 4. Divided by s plus 4 whole square plus 9 whole raised power 2. This is the easiest way to find out Laplace transform of product of polynomial into trigonometric and also exponential. Keep in mind, first you write the Laplace transform of trigonometric function and then operate with t and then operate with exponential. Now at a time we are using two results. Then and also easy to find out why I am not applying after sin 3t with shifting property, because shifting property is replace s by s plus 4 and then I have to differentiate, is very complicated. We get same answer, it's no, don't get it very easily. Because of that, I am going to advise the students, first you take trigonometric function and x multiplied with t and then you take exponential. Okay, now I think it's clear everyone how to solve this problem. Now I'm moving to the next problem. The next problem is cos at minus cos bt divided by t. I want to find out Laplace transform of cos at minus cos bt divided by t. Now I'm going to solve this problem by using which one? Second result, because you have a denominator t. Laplace transform of, if we want to go for this result, what we are going to do here? First you find out f of t. What is my f of t here? Cos at minus cos bt, numerator function. From the linear property, this can tell us Laplace transform of cos at minus Laplace transform of cos bt. Now, this is by using linear property. Linear. Okay, fine. In the next step, from the definition standard result, this can be written as s by s square plus a square. This is nothing but s by s square plus b square. Okay, fine. This is nothing but my capital F of s. Before we move into the next step, first you write the result, because that is not a mandatory to the result. Now, we know that Laplace transform of f of t by t is nothing but s to infinity capital F of s ds, where Laplace transform of f of t is nothing but capital F of s. This implies Laplace transform of cos at minus cos bt whole divided by t is nothing but s to infinity f of s. What is my f of s? S by s square plus a square minus s square plus b square with respect to s. Now I have to evaluate this. Integration of f dash of x divided by f of x is nothing but with respect to this is what? Log of f of x. Therefore, observe every year, what is derivative of x square plus a square is 2s. Which one is missing? 2 is missing. Therefore, first I have to multiply divided by 2. I will keep 1 by 2 outside. S to infinity 2s divided by x square plus a square with respect to s minus s to infinity, I take together only minus 2s divided by s square plus b square with respect to s. Observe, this is nothing but f dash of s divided by f of s. From the standard formula, now this can be written as, you already studied that formula, log of f of s. What is f of s? S square plus a square minus log of s square plus p square. What's the limit for this? Is to infinity. Now keep in mind, evaluation of integration fine, but while applying the limit for infinity, please take care that while applying the limit for any term, always are expecting, even though replace infinity, are expecting finite value. Suppose applying infinity directly here, what we get? S square is infinity, means log infinity. Log infinity is infinity. You don't get it finite value. Therefore, what we are going to do here, always write the S in the denominator. Why? Because 1 by infinity is 0. Then we get a finite value. Therefore, keep in mind, before going to apply the limit, first try to convert S in the denominator. Therefore, log A minus log B can be written as log of A by B. A square plus A square divided by A square plus B square. Fine. What's the limit? This is S to infinity. Now, just as I told, while applying the limit, always you are expecting S in the denominator. Therefore, better I to keep the limit. Don't apply the limit here. We get infinity by infinity. Now, it's an indeterminate form. Therefore, what we are going to do, I have to simplify this before going to apply the limit. I will take highest power of S in the numerator and denominator, then only we get S in the denominator. Once you take highest power of S in the numerator, what is actually S square into 1 plus A square by A square divided by highest power of S is S square into 1 plus B square by A square. What's the limit? Now I have to keep the limit as itself. Infinity, first I have to simplify that. Minus low limit as usual. Log of S square plus, because S only, divided by S square plus B square. Now what happened? S square cancel. Now apply the limit. What we get? 1 by infinity. What is 1 by infinity? 0. 1 plus 0 is 1. 1. Log 1 is. Now keep in mind, in the mathematics, log means have a base e. What is the value of log 1 base e? 0. Therefore, what we get, this limit value is 0. Now we get a minus half of log of a square plus a square divided by a square plus b square. You take that power in the log m log a. What is m log a? Log of a square plus a square divided by square plus b square to the power of minus half. Minus half means we get square root. A square plus b square comes in numerator, a square plus a square comes in denominator. Root of a square plus b square divided by a square plus a square. This is one of the standard function how to evaluate Laplace transform. Because once you have x to the power of minus half, what we are going to do? Do it 1 by root x. Like that, 1 by root, I am going to write what happened. Numerator comes in denominator, denominator comes in numerator. This is one of the standard function. How to find out Laplace transform? Cos at minus cos pt divided by t. Now, I am going to wind up the class. I am going to take further more problems in next my video. Thank you very much for listening. Suppose you like my video, please press like button and also subscribe. Thank you very much.